my god.
Okay, Beth has been sending me pastry murder videos since Evan and I broke up.
They look delicious.
Oh, yeah, no, she's an amazing baker. She would be so pissed if she found out that you and I were, you know, hanging out.
Hanging out? What, are you 12?
Oh, shut up! What am I supposed to call it?
Dating.
A couple.
A couple?
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. I can't believe I let you convince me to do this.
Oh, it'll be fun. Or it'll be terrible, just fun in its own way.
Hey, you're new. Welcome. I'm Erica, she, her.
Casey, Gardner.
Those are her pronouns.
Oh, sorry, I'm dumb.
No worries. Glad you're here. Come on, grab a seat and make yourself comfortable.
She's nice.
I mean, her nice. Pronouns thing. Okay.
I had a crush on a girl in first grade, and I was so excited. I told my best friend, but then she said I wasn't allowed to. I've had boyfriends, and well, I didn't realize. And then I got my first girlfriend, and everything felt so much more me. I don't know if that makes sense.
It does. Sorry. I didn't think I was gonna talk in here. I didn't even want to come. Now I'm making it worse.
Okay, well, I should go. I still have to study for this trig test.
Okay. I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, wait!
What?
I forgot to tell you what I heard about Penelope.
Ooh, tell me. No. It was the day I found out about Clayton. I was so excited. And I was on my way to Evan's on my bike. And yeah, I saw them in a parking lot, kissing.
That's, I'm so sorry.
I guess it's a good thing I don't know how to ride a bike. I'd probably ride by my mom doing all kinds of awful shit.
Wait. You can't ride a bike? Well, that will not do.
What do you mean? Stop scheming.
Come on.
Okay.
Steer?
I am.
Pedal?
I'm trying.
You suck at this.
I'm learning.
Dude, look where you're going. Oh my. Are you okay?
No. This was a terrible idea. Why do I need to learn how to ride a bike? I'm a klutz.
Oh, poor little klutz. You ready to try again? But I think you're worth it. Taste the strawberry sunscreen. Laughing it's on till the 90s. Holy crap, you're doing it!
Holy crap, I'm doing it!
What'd I say about leaving this door open?
Though wind blew it closed, there was a breeze. In fact, I think I feel it again.
Well, it's 8:00.
Time for Izzie to head out.
Okay.
And I'll take your phone.
I don't have a phone.
Very funny. But if you want to succeed at school and training and being a decent, rested human, it's time to go to bed.
I agree with her. Bye.
I'll call you in a second.
No, you will not. You will call her at 4 a.m. when you wake up.
No, you will not.
Hand it over.
I got a citation.
What? There's a rule on socks?
I guess. You see, these socks are strictly for running, but Clayton requires a different sock altogether for walking.
Really?
Ooh, they should put in a sock vending machine. I saw one of those at a bowling alley once. It was a very classy joint.
I wonder if undies are required too. Because ew, no, never.
No, it's literally just because we have to wear these dumb skirts. I mean, if boys wear gym socks, you can't see them because they're under their pants. We should say something.
Oh, I don't know. Well, I don't want to make a big fuss. And plus, Penelope's not wearing underwear. We should just drop it.
Hey. Sign my petition?
Abolish the Clayton dress code. Okay.
Look, I know you don't want to make a big deal out of it, but I don't think we have a choice. I mentioned it at the GSA meeting. And Casey, these dress codes are really upsetting to people. I mean, did you know it hasn't been changed in 100 years? Wow. Literally 100 years.
Well, did you tell the GSA about my sock vending machine idea?
And like, what if someone isn't comfortable having to prescribe to these gender norms? Mm-hmm. Like, just because I have a vulva, that means I have to wear a small skirt?
Is that the wording in the dress code?
Will you just sign it, please?
Okay. Yes. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to study for my history exam while I cram some lunch into my face, and then I have to finish my AP Lit reading before practice, so maybe later I'll do some bicep curls while delivering a litter of puppies. I'm not busy at all. Hey! Welcome to my brother's silly penguin party.
Very nice.
You look happy.
Yeah, well, I just got back from the GSA meeting, and it was so cool. I've never done anything like this. Plan a protest? It's so awesome.
Oh my god, Iz, I love that. I'm just...
What?
Would you be really mad if I didn't do it?
What?
I'm worried. I've just been working so hard and I don't want to get in trouble. And Crowley said... I just don't want to risk everything.
Okay, that's fine.
We're starting. Casey, we're starting. That's how I learned.
Can you feel the beating of the drum? Can you hear it louder than a gun? Can you see us staring down the wall? Can't deny us when you see it fall.
So it doesn't all fall apart.
Well,
this is not how we do things at Clayton Prep. Protests? Why didn't you just come talk to me? It never in a million years occurred to me that someone might have a problem with those beautiful uniforms, but I assure you, I would have listened.
Well, we did submit a petition.
Oh, we don't look at those. Look, you two are athletes. You are both here on scholarship. If you lose the support of Clayton Prep, say goodbye to this amazing, magical place forever.
We know.
And we didn't mean any disrespect. We just want to be heard.
Well, you have been. Loud and clear. You've also been seen. Now you're feeling the sting of punishment.
Are you going to do all the senses?
That snark just left a sour taste in my mouth.
I'm not sure what's going to happen to you two.
The school will decide from here.
Nothing. No new emails. I can't believe we haven't heard from Clayton yet.
I know, it's freaking me out. I mean, I'm glad we protested, but if we get suspended or expelled, there goes UCLA for both of us.
Yeah, that is what I've been saying this whole time.
I never said you were wrong. It's just, justice is more important. Hey, it's gonna be okay.
Do you think that's them coming here in person to tell us we're kicked out?
I preserved it in resin.
Wow.
Is that a dandelion?
Not just a dandelion. That's the world's best dandelion. It's large, perfectly round, every little white fluffer in place.
She is a beaut. How did you do it?
I paid my 9-year-old cousin in Florida $63 plus the cost of shipping to hunt one down, safely pack it in Tupperware and overnight it to me.
Wow.
After that, a trip to Michael's and a simple online class in resin flower preservation did the trick.
Very impressive.
So are we done with this now? We can agree, I am a Lady Shackleton.
Alas, this is merely the first task.
What's going on?
What are you up to, you rat?
Nothing. I'm just giving Paige a series of random and impossible tasks to prove that she's reliable.
That sounds dumb and mean.
It is. And I'm gonna crush it.
That's the spirit! Now. Hi. You saw the email, right? Did you see the email?
Who is this?
Oh, shut up. Did you see the email? From Vice Principal Patrick. He loves us. We're not suspended.
We're not suspended?
Nope. We got a warning.
What? That's amazing.
I know, right? I never thought I'd be so happy to have to go to school.
Wait, I didn't get an email yet. Why didn't I get an email yet?
Maybe they're going alphabetically, Gardner before Taylor. I mean, who cares? We're not suspended.
We're not suspended.
Okay, I'm gonna go celebrate the Clayton way by doing 1,000 hours of homework and then maybe some training. So, send me a hot selfie?
No, thanks. Have fun. I am going to have a Twinkie.
All right, bye.
Goodbye.
So, turns out Paige is a raving lunatic. Who knew?
You mean because she thought the test that you designed to humiliate her was unkind?
Exactly. I mean, she's not totally wrong. I was stressed about Clayton stuff, and this is weird, but I think maybe, in a way, I was hoping to get kicked out.
What?
I just never felt like I fit in there. And this year has been so hard that it just felt like an easy way out of all the stress. But now that we're safe, I'm relieved.
I'm not safe.
What?
I got the email. I'm suspended.
What? No, I got a warning.
Yeah, well, I guess I'm not you.
This was sweet of you. As long as you don't start sleeping in here again. No more of that.
No, I'm done with that.
We're still waiting for this crazy plan of his to go away, right?
Actually, no. If I've learned anything lately, it's that life is short. And if Sam wants to go to Antarctica, he should go to Antarctica. As soon as he can.
I don't get it. Why did you get suspended and not me? Maybe it's because you organized it?
Yeah, maybe.
What?
I'm just thinking about how she's not gonna be surprised.
Who?
My mom. In second grade, I had this really cool matchbox car. It was a Camaro. And at recess, this boy James took it, and he wouldn't give it back.
Did you murder him?
I pushed him.
That's my girl.
I was sent to the principal, and they called my mom. And I thought I was gonna be in so much trouble. But you know what she did? Mm-hmm. She laughed. Mm. She expects me to get kicked out. And here I am.
Hey, you didn't get kicked out. You're just taking a mandatory rest from your exhausting work as a crusader for justice, that's all.
I'm just scared I'm gonna miss everything. Classes, track, all the crazy stuff you get up to.
Don't worry about that. Elsa grounded me. I mean, I'm still allowed to run and go to school and go to practice, so it's basically meaningless, but still. How dare she?
Promise you won't have any fun without me.
I couldn't.
Oh, look at you without your other half. So sad and pathetic. Like when you find one sock randomly lying in the street without its match.
Thank you.
How is Izzie? Did she die of loneliness yet or what?
She might have. I haven't heard from her in 3 minutes or so.
Yeah, I'll let you know. I'm gonna see her today.
Oh, you are?
Yeah. She asked me to bring her homework. We have a physics test, and it's brutal. She asked Hazel and not you? Uh-oh. That does not seem like a good sign.
Shut up. So, is Hazel your new girlfriend or what?
I had to ask her to bring it. You're grounded, remember?
You didn't answer my question. That worries me.
Is that my take-home test?
I'm holding it hostage till you tell me I'm your one and only. Wow. You realize this is the first time I'm seeing your room. I love it. It's so you. Nice YA collection. Whoa, is this a secret box of jelly beans?
Shh. Do you want three kids busting in here tearing that box to shreds?
Sorry. Can I have some jelly beans?
Oh. You're my one and only.
All right.
Ugh. I suck at physics.
I'm back!
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. Is that your mom? Can I meet your mom?
Please, no.
We're in here!
Casey, look at you! I am so glad to finally meet you. This one's been keeping you from me.
Hi, Mrs. Taylor.
Sasha.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Oh. Wow, you have amazing energy. Like, your aura is really stunning. You're glowing.
Oh, I mean, I jogged here, so I'm just sweaty.
I like you. You're a good one. I can tell. Ooh, can I do your tarot? Sure.
Nope.
I'll go set up the space.
Okay. Come on, it'll be fun.
That has not been my experience.
Have a jelly bean and be happy.
I don't want a jelly bean.
Gosh, aren't we just the cutest?
This is exciting. I've never done tarot before. Is that even the right way to say it? Done tarot?
No, the right way to say it is let's go hang out in my room instead.
Izzie thinks that this is all very silly. She's always been very literal.
Well, I don't think you're a magical fairy who can tell the future. So if that's literal, I guess I am.
Place them into one deck, please.
Oh.
Oh, wow. I knew it. Oh, Izzie, you're so lucky to be under her canopy.
Mm. What? What do they mean? They're pretty.
I have a lot of homework, so.
Please. Here's what I see. Adventure, hope, positivity. And you'll never be alone. You have a quiet power that other people want to follow. Now, it may not end up like you expected it to, but your path ahead is full of light and luck. And this, my dear, is you.
Why haven't I done tarot before? I didn't know it was just free compliments. All right, your turn.
No.
Come on.
Fine.
Oh, boy. Oh, wow. Those look really different from mine. Did that poor buffalo get stabbed in the eye?
Look at that darkness. I mean, it explains the attraction. The light and the dark.
I'm done.
Her cards are always like this. I started doing her readings when she was 7 years old, and there was so much anger and bitterness, even then.
Why would a 7-year-old be bitter? Oh, maybe it's because she's busy making her sister a bottle while her mom sleeps one off.
I see.
Well, I have had my hard times, but I certainly did everything I could.
No, you haven't. And I'm done here.
I'm gonna sage you before you go. A lot of intense energy in here, huh?
Okay.
She makes me crazy. That's not an expression. She makes my brain break, and then I go crazy.
Yeah, I get it. But I mean, it's just stupid tarot.
You don't get it. Because you're a fawn in the woods, and I'm a bison with swords in its eyes. You know, I don't really think I'm in the mood to hang out. Maybe you should go.
I can sit here quietly. I'll be a very quiet fawn in the woods.
No, Casey, please. Please leave.
Come on. Don't take out your anger at your mom on me.
Actually, I think I might also be angry at you.
What? Why?
I told you I didn't want to hang out with my mom.
Okay, well, I wanted to meet her.
And you did, and of course she loves you.
What does that mean?
It's the same reason why I got suspended and you didn't. You have this charmed life, and usually it's whatever, but right now it's really hard to deal with. That's why I asked Hazel to bring me my test and not you.
What? That's not...
Just go. Please. I need some space. Are you the girl I gave my test to? My brother scribbled all over this one, but you can still read it. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm always saying that to you. I'm sorry I'm always saying that to you.
It's okay. I pushed to meet her. Maybe I shouldn't have.
You're my girlfriend. Of course you should meet my mom. I just feel like I'm going crazy not going to school. It's so hard to do anything at home, I can't focus.
Yeah, I get it. So, you think I'm some golden child that everyone has to tiptoe around?
I know your life isn't perfect. I know you're not perfect. It's just, you have these parents that support you so much, it drives you nuts. It's the opposite for me. You have a support system. I am a support system.
I'll be your support system. I'll do whatever you need.
Can you help me get good at physics? Because I think I blew this test.
I was thinking something more like...
Casey!
Look at me, I'm supporting!
Well, at least you hung in there longer than your girlfriend.
Where is my girlfriend?
Now you got energy?
Doctors say taking a walk is one of the healthiest things you can do.
Thank you.
A simple walk can kill you.
Your mom made six pies.
I couldn't sleep, so I baked. Pies for my sweetie pies. How was training?
It was hell. Thanks for asking.
Yeah, well, I'm thinking Thursday we're gonna drive up to Bear Mountain. It's about a 6-mile loop. It's really pretty up there.
Great. I'll die in nature.
Oh, I'm getting changed.
So, what are you two lazy butts talking about?
Gosh, what were we two lazy butts talking about?
I'm trying to convince your mom to come to the Parents Association meeting this week. Mm. The GSA got the dress code on the agenda.
Well, she's not really the PTA type.
Haha. So you're not giving up on this dress code issue, huh?
No, I can't. I mean, it's not about clothes, it's about identity. I mean, who are we to tell someone what gender expression works for them? That's not my choice to make for someone else, and it certainly isn't the school's choice.
Then I will be there. And I shall bring pie. What have you done to my beautiful baby's hands?
There's someone at the door. You should get that as the lady of the house. Ow.
Oh my God. You will not believe this. I got an A on my physics take-home test.
Oh, wow.
Which is awesome and strange. And then after class, Mr. Ryan asked me all these questions about where I took the test and whether I was supervised by anyone. And then he mentioned the Clayton Moral Code. And I realized this guy thinks I cheated. I was so pissed. I mean, I may suck at physics, but I'm not a cheater.
Oh, no. What did you tell him?
I told him that was a completely inappropriate accusation and that he should feel ashamed of himself, and then I stomped out. I mean, he's lucky I didn't smash his little model catapult.
I did it.
What?
I looked at the test you gave me and I changed a couple answers. I'm so sorry. You missed a couple, and so I filled them out, and then I kept going.
Do you, like, feel bad for me? Do you think I'm dumb?
No, not at all. You said it was your worst subject, so I was just trying to be supportive. I'll go talk to him. I'll tell him it was all me.
He can't prove anything. That's why he wants me to admit it. Just drop it.
I'm sorry. Are you mad? Really?
Yeah. I gotta get to class.
Izzie and I are fighting right now, too. She's mad at me, even though I was just trying to help her.
Hi.
Hi. I'm sorry.
I know, and maybe I overreacted. I don't know how to explain this. Our lives are so different. When my mom has insomnia, she drinks herself to sleep. When your mom has insomnia, she bakes pie. I just felt like you saw what my life was like and thought less of me.
What? No. I saw how hard things are and I wanted to help. I just did it in a really dumb way. Look, there's so much I don't know about myself right now. But I know that I'm a protector. And if I think someone I love is in trouble, I try to help.
You love me?
Of course I love you.
I love you too.
I have something for you.
What is this?
Isn't it obvious? It's tarot.
You made these?
I figured you deserve at least one good reading in your lifetime. Oh, this is an excellent one, actually.
Good.
Slurpee card. You are brave. Brave enough to tell people how you feel, even if it's scary. People follow you because you are wise. And very, very beautiful. Listen to the magic of the tarot.
Okay.
Next, the winged shoe.
Mm-hmm.
You are fast as the wind. Your courage will take you far. And you are very, very beautiful. And finally, ooh, this one is especially witchy. The righteous voice. You care. And you speak up for people. Because no one ever spoke up for you.
That is why I do it.
And you are very. Hey, so I was looking through your bag to find a t-shirt to steal.
Invasive.
And you realize that all you packed are like a bunch of socks and a sports bra, right?
Yeah, I know. I packed up pretty quickly. My mom kicked me out.
Oh. I didn't... What happened?
Oh, you know, just my mom being my mom. I was gonna tell you, but I didn't want to talk about it right away.
It's okay. I understand.
Do you want to go to a party? Erica's having some people over and it might be fun.
I love fun. But what about the track meet? I mean, shouldn't we be like, resting up?
Probably.
Mm.
But I told her I'd be there. But it's okay. I'll just go by myself.
No. I'll go with you.
You will?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, I love parties and I love people, so I'm kind of a party person.
Okay. Thank you.
At least it's a cute bet, though.
I appreciate the Days of the Week underwear. You know, you lose track of time, you just glance at your tush.
Right. Oh, you two are like the perfect couple. I am never gonna find this.
Oh, no, we have issues, too.
Yeah, she has really sharp toenails. They're actually more like talons.
Mm. She just did a test for me last week.
No, are you serious?
Yeah, but I'm not mad about it anymore. There is just this one tiny thing that still bothers me.
What?
Well, I just know if the school found out, nothing would happen to Casey. Like if she just walked in there and turned herself in. But if they thought it was me, I mean, I would be kicked out for sure. Casey's just, like, untouchable.
That, no way. That's crazy.
I'll bet you $100.
Oh!
That's not true.
What, that I have $100? You're right about that.
Hey, Izzie, breakfast?
Oh, no, it's okay. Just coffee, please.
How about just eggs and bacon and fruit and pie?
I mean, okay. Thank you.
Check this out. It's from UCLA.
What is this? Are you opening my mail?
Well, I'm sorry, it said UCLA. I got excited. It's an official letter of interest. That means they're really interested in you. They're even gonna send a recruiter to watch you run at the next race.
My little speedster.
I am so proud of you, Casey.
Me too. It's happening.
For both of us.
No, for you.
No time to let up now. Pedal to the metal, right?
You didn't really turn yourself in, did you?
I tried. You were right. I guess I owe you $100.
Why would you do that? Because of what I said at the party? I was just being dumb. I didn't want you to actually do it.
Yeah, I know. I felt like I had to.
Okay, well, I'm glad you didn't get suspended. We need you. The team needs you. You're important. You know it's okay for people to recognize you're special.
Ugh. It was less stressful when no one noticed me at all.
Hey. You think that's her?
Yeah, I guess.
Come on, let's ask. Oh my God, I thought you were dead. Are you okay? What happened? You just walked off. Are you hurt?
No.
Are you sick?
No, I'm...
What?
I don't know.
You're freaking me out.
I couldn't do it.
Do what? Run?
Yeah. It was just too much. People expect too much from me.
Okay.
I just couldn't breathe.
Oh, no.
I mean, track used to be fun. It used to be the only time I could breathe. But today I couldn't.
Okay. Okay. It's okay.
Instead of people being happy for Mighty Mo, they were worried. They thought it was too much for a young girl to handle.
Slow down!
Hi.
Hey, I missed you. Get over here.
You seem so good. I'm glad you seem so good.
I feel good. I haven't run in a week.
Whoa, really?
Yeah.
You're gonna have to work hard to get back into shape.
No, I won't.
Cocky again, too. I love it.
No, I mean, I'm quitting track.
What? Why? You love track. And you're on your way to UCLA. I know it. And if you quit, you're gonna lose your Clayton scholarship.
I know all that. And I've thought about this. a lot. I used to love running so much. It was the only thing I loved that much. And ever since the UCLA stuff, the love has just changed. It's become stress and anxiety. It's a pit in my stomach.
No. I mean, running is who you are. It's who we are.
No, it's not. I can do this. It feels good to know that I can quit at any time.
And what about Clayton?
I don't like Clayton. I never did. I like you. And I don't want to lose you. But we don't have to go to the same school to be together.
Maybe you just need more time.
No, I don't. I'm doing this. After years of all that stress, Mighty Mo quit running. Don't worry. And hey, now I'm gonna have a lot more time for the things I love. Like you. Well, you're not a thing. Mm. You're a person. I used to hate that part of her story. Yeah, I made the big decision about UCLA, and then I made a different big decision that my girlfriend wasn't too thrilled about.
Girlfriend, that's new, right?
Yeah. But it's kind of complicated right now. Yeah, we went to this meeting, me and Izzie, at the GSA at school. And she just felt like they got her. Like she found a community there immediately. And I feel like she knows herself better. And I feel like I'm not supposed to not know. I've just done all this work on myself, in my head, trying to figure out what I want. And breaking up with Evan was so hard. And I love Izzie. So much. But I just feel like that's not enough.
Have you talked to Casey? She wants to quit track.
I heard.
Well, I think she means it.
Me too.
Is that all? Oh, we need to do something. We need to help her.
I'm not thrilled about it, but it's her life.
Look, I know we don't talk much, but I'm worried about your daughter, and you should be too.
I am worried about Casey. I have been all year. She's fallen apart, and I've never seen her like that. And you know what's new? You. All your drama. So yeah, I am worried. I'm worried that the thing that's making her life so hard right now is you. But she won't admit it, so she's blaming running.
I'm glad we drove out here to get these. I mean, it's weird that they're the only one with the root beer flavor. It's clearly the best one. Hey, are you okay?
I think we need to break up.
What?
I'm not good for you. You haven't been yourself the last few months. You've been stressed and anxious and pulling away from anything that's not school.
What? No.
And now you want to quit track. This isn't you. Everything changed once we started dating. I don't want to be the reason you don't do the things you want to do.
But that's not even
what I'm sorry.
Izzie.
Wow. You're really doing it. You're leaving.
Yeah.
It's not because of me, is it?
No. I mean, you know better than anyone. I don't want to be here. I never have.
If you want to talk.
I'm not ready to.
Okay. I just wanted to ask you, I got an invitation to your brother's going away party and I wanted to go. For Sam.
Yeah.
Is that weird?
Well, you should know it's also a party for a testicle, so.
Yeah. The Evite was very clear.
It's not weird. You should come.
Okay. Is your dad gonna be there?
Yeah, probably. Why? What the hell did you do?
Whoa.
You told Izzie she wasn't good for me? Why would you do that?
No, she came down here to talk to me and it just slipped out. And I'm sorry if I hurt her feelings, but what I said, it was the truth.
No, it's not. But it doesn't matter because you got what you wanted. We broke up.
I'm sorry, Casey.
No, you're not.
Casey.
Don't talk to me.
Casey.
Aw, well, aren't you two just the cutest? Is Izzie coming tonight?
Yeah, I think so.
But to most people, it just looks like magic.
I know it's late.
It's okay.
That wasn't fair, what you did. Breaking up with me like that, it wasn't fair. I mean, if you break up with me because you're not in love with me, fine. It makes me want to puke, but fine.
That's not it.
But if it's because you think it's what's best for me, that is so condescending. I can decide what's best. I can decide what I need.
I know.
And just because I'm having a hard time doesn't mean that I'm broken.
I didn't know what to do.
All you had to do was be there. Just be my girlfriend.
But that was the problem. Me being your girlfriend was making everything worse.
Why would you think that?
Because it's true. I mean, think about when we met. I was so mean. And then we got together and I kissed someone else. It's what I do. I ruin things. I'm a ruiner.
Stop it. Don't talk about yourself like that.
It was condescending. I just convinced myself that I was gonna mess things up with us. And when you were so, so upset, I blamed myself. But you're right. I shouldn't have. And now all I wanna do is kiss you.
I'm okay with that.
Are we still a couple when you go back to Newton?
Yeah, of course.
My mom isn't here. Do you wanna stay?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you sure you're ready to?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that a tattoo?
Yeah, I'm a bad boy. So, this thing happened. Elsa tricked me. You think she's nice, but she's nothing but trouble.
Mm-hmm.
She completely lied to me. She made me eat healthy snacks. She talked my ear off.
What are you trying to tell me?
I met with a scout from UCLA.
Wow. So did I.
Really?
Yeah.
Emily?
Emily.
Holy crap.
I know. I don't know if it's gonna happen. But if either of us gets in, that person needs to go. Whether or not the other one does. Promise?
Promise.
Forehead promise?
Forehead promise.